In this video, I'm going to show you how to hive a swarm. It's funny because the day that we wanted to hive a swarm, we actually had a swarm in the apiary, so it works out perfectly. So I'm standing beside a swarm. I want to talk a little bit about the biology of the swarm, what you can think about when you see the swarm, and how to actually get it into a hive. But first, the biology. Swarms are a colony's way of reproducing. One of the colonies in our apiary here at the University of Florida Honeybee Research and Extension Laboratory split itself in half. What happened is the old queen and some population of the worker bees left that hive, clustered here, and is looking for a new home. Back at the original hive, they're investing in making a new queen. Once the new queen emerges, she'll take over as the reigning matriarch in that nest. She'll be the mom, she'll lay the eggs, etc. But this one is a baby bee hive. It's got in it a queen and all the bees necessary to move into a new cavity to create that new colony. So this particular formation, beekeepers refer to as a swarm. The act of doing this is called swarming. So swarms, swarm, and here we have this cluster of bees that we refer to as a swarm. So what happened? Well, when that hive split and all of those bees came out of it, they were flying in the air with the old queen, and once they pick a spot to land, they'll form this cluster. So somewhere in this swarm is the queen. At this point, the worker bees are sending off other bees to scout the countryside looking for cavities in which to move. Once they find a cavity that they prefer, they will drop from this cluster and fly en masse to that cavity. This is why some beekeepers will be called to remove a swarm from someone's property, and by the time they get there, the swarm is no longer there. That's because the swarm found a new home and moved. We caught this swarm in time to actually hive it before it found its home and moved. So really, hiving a swarm is quite simple. First thing you need is a swarm. We've got that. The second thing you need is the hive. And as I crouch down, I've set up right underneath this swarm a full-size Langstroth hive. You'll notice it's a 10-frame hive, but I've already taken out a few of those frames to create the empty space here in the middle of the hive. And at this point, it's really simple. A lot of people overthink hiving swarms, but in reality, to get this swarm in this box, all you have to do is shake this tree limb. It's really that simple. But a couple of things before I do that. This was a very convenient swarm. It landed very close to the ground, you know, within a meter of the ground, within 3 feet or so. So it's really easy to put a hive under it, shake the bees into it. Often swarms will be a few meters or a few feet in trees or maybe even higher, 20 meters. Very high, very difficult to reach. But the ones that are close to the ground are, quite frankly, easy to hive. So what a lot of beekeepers will do is they'll shake the bees into the hive and they may comb through those bees to look for the queen. Because one of the things that you have to remember with swarms is they want to move to a new nest site. So occasionally when you shake them into a new hive body, they might swarm again instantly within a few minutes. So if you're able to go through that cluster and find the queen, you can cage the queen, put her in the hive, and the bees will remain. Of course, you release the queen a few days later and life is good. In this particular case, I'm not going to worry about looking for the queen. I'm simply going to shake the bees into the hive, let the bees disperse a little bit. I'll return the combs to the hive, put a lid on the hive, and then I've got a jar of sugar syrup ready to where I can start feeding the swarm to make them want to stay even more. Two more last pointers. Hiving a swarm and keeping that swarm in the hive often works best when you give them pulled comb. So for example, we have frames of pulled comb. It even works better if you give them a frame of brood from another hive just to give them a reason to stay in the box. And once I hive this swarm, I might close it up and move it to another apiary. I might put it in the same apiary, but regardless of what option you do, it's a really good idea to usually start with pulled comb or a frame of brood to make sure they stay in the nest. With that background, it's really this simple. I'm going to grab the tree branch, try to give it a good shake, make sure the majority of the bees get into this nest, and once they do, I'll return the combs to the nest. So let me just start here. It's that easy. Again, if I were super paranoid about the queen, I might check in the box to ensure that she's in that box, but I'm going to assume that I got her since most of the bees are gone from that limb. Now keep in mind, these bees will still smell the pheromone of the queen on the tree limb, so you might get some residual bees going back to that branch, but as long as you have her in the box, it should be okay. You return the lid, and the bees will start using the entrance of the hive, slowly moving away from this tree branch. A couple of things really help out in that regard. Once the bees that you've shaken into this nest recognize this nest as their own, you'll see bees at the nest entrance with their abdomens in the air, fanning Nazanov pheromone. That's a homing pheromone that calls the other bees that are flying around to their new nest site. Some beekeepers will actually shake the swarm in front of the entrance of the hive, because as bees walk into the nest, they will deposit footprint pheromones or trailing pheromones, which shows the other bees the direction of the nest. I've already got Nazanov gland being exposed on the entrance. I've got some bees walking in. They now recognize this as their new hive. I would just simply return the lid, maybe come back in 20 minutes once most of the bees are in the box, and then move the hive where I want to put it, feed it, and it's really that simple.